This is one of the more interesting aspects of the equipment move. All the other pieces prior to these have gone on their own wheels. These are going to have to go on railroad flat cars. For various reasons, age and condition, the two smaller steam locomotives in our collection really weren't fit to move on their own wheels. So rather than take a chance and put them out there on a busy main line, we decided to load them onto flat cars. We're using Crocker Crane, which we've used for years, and they're going to lift the two steam locomotives and the two tenders that go with them onto three flat cars that are on loan from BNSF Railway. It's going to save us about $45,000 in trucking costs to have these flat cars loaned to us by BNSF. The tender that they just put on the flat car was around 55,000 pounds. That was the easy lift. The difficult one is about to come up. The locomotive behind us weighs about 200,000 pounds, and they'll have to lift it with two cranes and swing it over onto this flat car.
As a lifelong railroad fan, I'm out here today to see the preservation of the equipment that's been here at Fair Park for a number of years, moved to its new home in the city of Frisco. And we're really looking forward to that because Frisco is a railroad town. It started that way and is still that way. So I think it's a very appropriate place for the equipment to be. You've got much more space available so that the trains can be displayed in their full, if you want to call it beauty, mechanical brilliance, whatever, but that's the exciting part about being in Frisco.
Well, these are two fairly prominent pieces in our collection. The Frisco 1625, the larger of the two engines we're moving today, actually started out life as a locomotive that was going to be shipped to Russia. It was built by American Locomotive Company of Schenectady, New York, but it was going to be shipped over to the Imperial Russian Railways. The order was completed in 1917, right about the time the Bolshevik Revolution took place. The order was canceled. And the builder was stuck with an order of locomotives that didn't even run on American gauge tracks. These were built to 5-foot gauge. So they took them back, ran them through the plant again, and re-gauged them for use on American tracks. And about that time, the U.S. entered the First World War. So the U.S. Railway Administration, which was with the government takeover of the railroads during World War I, they took the engine and operated it for a couple of years. Then it was sold as military surplus to the Frisco Railroad, where it had a long career. Frisco retired it. It was sold again to the Eagle Pitcher Mining Company of Cardin, Oklahoma, where the infamous lead mine is. It actually worked that facility for another 10 or 12 years before finally being retired in 1962. It's had a long history, and it makes it a very interesting piece for the collection.